everyone. Happy to have you here for another episode of Legacy Matters. Our show is growing, and the lives and legacies of the people around us have taken on a new importance as we take stock of what is most precious to us. As always, our show will focus on building and preserving your legacy, the importance of community, and the telling of stories we find amusing. Thanks for joining us. Now, enjoy the show. Everyone, we did it. We're here.
Yay!
So,
to our guest, I forgot to tell you before the show.
Yeah,
we're gonna talk for just a moment, and then we'll introduce you. So here
Great.
We go. Yeah. So shh.
Yeah, even better.
It'll be more of a surprise.
Yep.
Talk as much first as half like. Hour.
Don't tell the audience.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, don't tell anyone. And they're like, God, does this dude not know how to edit?
Yeah, exactly. Do they know it's on?
So hour two, they bring in the guests.
They don't know it's on.
They do this every time. Hi, you two.
Hi.
How's it going?
Busy.
Oh,
are we
busy?
On? Are we going now?
I told you we were going. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
I didn't see you push play. I'm good. I'm busy. How about you?
I mean, it says we're 40 seconds into it. I think.
Oh,
it's
nice. We're doing a great job already. Then.
We're killing it.
Consistency. That's what we're all about.
This is why people tune in.
I know. They're like, God, what could happen now? Yeah. I'm good, Sam. I'm busy. How about you? How about you, Kate? Yeah.
That really?
Yeah.
Is it because winter's going on?
No.
So long?
No.
What? You just been busy too?
Do I share?
You had an adulting day. You had
I
to
did.
Be an adult.
I did.
That's a weird day for some of
today
us.
Today you had to be an adult?
I did.
Yeah.
Do you get a lot of days where you don't have to be an adult?
I do.
Yeah.
Don't pretend
that
like
sucks.
You don't either.
I have three kids at
right.
home.
Right. Yeah.
I get so few days where I don't have to do adult shit.
I don't have children, so almost every day is a day where I can pick.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's super fun, you guys.
Yeah.
Sorry to...
I've heard of it.
Sorry.
It's okay.
But...
totally
we made
you.
Our choices.
And, yeah. and yep. I'm not upset with you for it. Or,
no.
You
know.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks.
So when it does happen, it's kind of like, what the hell was that?
Yeah. Yeah.
So let's give your... So what did you do for an adulting day? Just real curious.
Nutshell?
Yeah.
Boyfriend and I signed our estate planning and our wills.
Wow. Oh, that's
yeah. That's like for serious. Yeah.
I mean,
it's fine, but that's
oh, it's great actually.
Yeah.
But I mean,
it's like
we're
checking
not,
a box.
We're not married, but now yeah. I won't be homeless when he dies but, before me, as he likes to
see?
Point out.
Well, that's nice.
Right.
At least there's a plan.
But how long yeah. have you two been together?
It'll be 7 years this summer.
Yeah, I mean, you have a history. There's a reason I understand you don't necessarily want to get married.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
maybe that commitment or whatever, but you're effectively married.
Well, there's common law. So
it feels more serious than saying I do, if I'm being honest.
Yeah, you're like
that's why
we're filling paperwork
oh,
out.
Oh, my God.
I
told Mark, it's more signatures and initials than when you buy a house.
Yeah.
I just get a kick out of all that shit because it's like whether it's banking or things like wills and stuff. It's like you start with nothing, you put some shit on paper, and then it's like, well, paper's sitting here in front of us. You know, if you don't sign this, then nothing we said over here matters. It's all bullshit.
Yeah.
But if you put your little fucking signature on there, then we're holding you to everything that's in this. It's very weird. It's like...
It's legal.
Yeah, I know. But it's also... It's legal, but it's also stupid and fake kind of, too, like, in a certain way.
You could burn it.
Yeah, like...
And
like my
maybe no
somebody
one would ever
would
know.
Still know.
Like, maybe. I mean, the devil. If the devil's, like, signed this, I'm like, okay, yeah, you're fucking right. No, I'm going to take this real seriously. But the rest of it...
Yeah.
No, I'm going to get to the guest.
I know. Okay, I was cool, like, we fine. Should probably sit down.
We should. What are we doing?
We're just chatting like we always do.
Right.
I know, but I did want to say, just real quick, a little plug for your business. Are you busy because you're opening up a new restaurant for First Abs Company? Is that what
yes, I am, and I can't say anything until April 3rd.
Oh, I didn't say it.
Yeah, it's fine. No, I can tell you. Yes, I am, but I can't tell you what it is yet.
No, that's good. That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's pretty exciting. So good for you. I'm sure you're busy as shit.
Sure.
Speaking of restaurants and
openings.
Nice. Well, you know what? Round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I did that. It's like I'm a pro at this. We have a guest.
Change the cue card.
Yes.
And shit, she told me your last name just a moment ago, and I was like, I can remember that one.
Nope.
I only know her as Heather. Yeah. So, like, and you know why I only know you as Heather? Can you take a guess?
because my restaurant's named Heather's.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. It's not. There's another person in town whose restaurant bears his last name. I know that guy's last name like crazy.
Right.
I don't know his first name. You know what I'm saying?
I do. D.
So, Heather, what is your last name?
Asbury.
Asbury.
Mm-hmm. Heather Asbury. From
Welcome.
Heather's.
Yes,
from
thank
Heather's.
Thank you. I'm excited
the
to
restaurant.
Be here. Yes.
We had that conversation.
Yeah, we already, I think we put that out there, Mark.
Yeah, no. Was that being recorded?
I'm pretty sure we're on.
Okay.
Yeah, Heather's, by the way, is, so we, people know this, I didn't tell these two who was coming on the show.
Oh, they're never
like,
do.
Yeah, okay, welcome. I'm a surprise.
We're literally meeting and like, tell us.
Oh, that's
so that's the point of the show.
Oh,
this
fun.
Is Legacy Matters, and the point of the show is that you come in and it's like, we all know each other quite well. You can maybe tell that.
Yes,
right?
I can.
And then you're the newbie in town.
Yeah,
and we're like,
know?
Hey, so what's up with you?
Yeah.
So you just moved in down the block. What do you think of this place? So that's what this whole show is about.
That's awesome. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course. Of course. So we'll just, we'll ask a little bit about your career or your life first.
So are you new to the neighborhood? I'm guessing not.
Well, I moved to the restaurant opened March 17th of 2020.
Oh, wow.
So the day the
March
whole world
came
to
take out.
That's some timing right there.
That was our grand opening day. So never did we didn't really ever get to have a big celebration of our grand opening. Yeah. But
no, I mean, you could have just all stood around in that church parking lot and been like,
that's what we did for holidays. People would do the little parking lot circles and stay 6 feet apart eat meals together.
Yeah, what a weird world.
Eat meals together apart.
Talk about having
in the back of their trunks.
Pivot quick, like, okay, we're doing this now.
Yeah.
I would have saved a lot of money had I not bought plates and tables and chairs.
Oh, boy.
But that's okay. Yeah. Worked out the way it was supposed to be. So.
You know why it worked out the way it did?
This
is my when I interject like a large amount of sarcasm, certain sarcasm, or sometimes I do anyway.
Okay.
No, I'm just curious if you know why it worked out so
well. Well, I think it's because I picked a fabulous neighborhood to be in.
That's one. That's one reason. Yeah. Okay, I'll give you that one. Anything else?
Because people didn't want to see me go out of business. I don't know.
No, because your food is fucking delicious.
Oh, thank you.
There's a good
thing. Honest to God, it is
I call that
really,
leading,
really good.
But it works.
Yeah.
No,
thank you. I appreciate that.
It stands out as being good. So if you know, there's a lot of nice places around Minneapolis. And those of us who've lived here forever can attest to the fact that there weren't always.
Yep. Yeah.
True.
Back when.
Yep.
There have been for a long time. There's been a lot of food going on in Minneapolis, but your place is awesome.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
We did pivot quickly. We were going to be a little bit more upscale. And the day that we went to takeout, I was like, I'm not sure upscale's the direction we should go.
Yeah.
So we kind of rewrote the menu real quickly.
Which is super easy to do, to quickly rewrite an entire menu.
Oh, yeah. He's got a history in the restaurant business.
Oh, my God. He's like, no, we're doing this now.
Yeah,
that's a lot.
I like to change things up a lot.
Yeah.
So, so the neighborhood came out and supported us, and the building that we were in was vacant for 16 years, and a man actually lived in the basement and let all the weeds overgrow and everything. So the whole neighborhood.
I had my eye on that building.
Yeah, the whole neighborhood was just waiting for something to go in there.
Yeah.
And then for the pandemic to hit right then, they were all like, whoops, this isn't going to work for us. Oh. So they all.
Or is it?
Rallied.
Yeah.
I know they showed up every day.
That's awesome.
They were really awesome. So
you're a half a mile. Well, you're very close to my house.
Yes.
So what neighborhood are we talking about?
Like Lake Nokomis.
Lake Nokomis, right? Yeah.
Yep. It's like the Field Hale neighborhood.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The other side from us.
Yep.
But still very close.
Yes.
Yeah. A lot of young families and.
Oh, and there's nothing over there.
Yeah. Yeah. No, we got really lucky.
Blue plate or something. You know,
I mean, they're far enough away that it's like we kind of picked something like the idea that we'd have coffee and lunch and breakfast and ice cream and don't worry, there's 25 reasons you need to come here today.
Oh, I love that.
So
and then you sell great stuff out of there too.
Well,
like you can just walk in and have like a little cooler full of stuff, and I'm like, oh, I'll take some of these home with me too.
I like to do too much.
Yeah.
That's kind of my thing.
Options.
Does that get you in trouble?
Probably with my chef, but
there you go.
But he's learning. He's like, oh, here we go again.
Well, does he want a job or not?
Yeah, exactly. No, he's wonderful. I love him a lot. So, and he's been there since day one.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. I think
that's good.
Chef
kinda,
shout out.
Yeah,
for sure.
What's his name?
Wilson Lucero. He's amazing.
Wilson Lucero.
Yeah, he's. He is just like the right palate. Awesome. He's got an awesome team behind him. Good.
Anytime you get that kind of continuity, that's a big
deal.
He
came by originally before we opened and said, you know, I'm in between jobs. And this is in my neighborhood and I just want to help you get open. And then pandemic hit and he never left and here we are.
That's how they get you. Yeah. Try before you buy. First one's free.
Yeah, exactly.
That's really sweet.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it worked out great. So I'm very lucky.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, where are you from originally?
From Edina.
Okay, so you are a Minnesotan. So have we buttered you up enough? Like, is it really tough to sit there and hear, like, nice things about yourself? No, you're from Edina. Yeah. You're maybe more used to that than the rest of us. See how I did that?
Slam. Oh, wow. High school slam right there.
I'm not high-fiving that.
I kind of cringe when I have to tell people where I'm from when they're, like, from the neighborhood. Oh, yeah, where are you from? And I want to say so bad, like,
Minnesota.
You lie two blocks away.
Yeah. But I'm like, Minneapolis.
Yep. I'm originally from Minnesota. Yeah. You can say that.
There
that's
you go.
True.
Yeah, the
I'm
whole
from the
state.
Metro area.
Yeah. I love that whole Edina thing. Like, it's just so fun.
Yep.
It's fun, like, saying bad things about St. Paul when St. Paul is such a nice city.
Yeah, exactly. Trash it. And it's never done anything to us, but right, it's nice to go, it's just lame.
I'll tell you, their roads are shit in the winter.
Oh, God, they are right now.
But other than that, it's a lovely city. Mm-hmm.
Just as long as you don't go there.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't cross the river often.
St. Paul is nice from the side of the river.
It's really nice
you
from
sons
afar.
Of bitches. Yeah.
It's
like a sunset. It's pretty, but you don't want to go over there.
So you grew up in Edina.
Yep.
Drove you into restaurants?
I was going to say, this is not your first venture.
That's an interesting question. Yeah, I've always chose food. Yeah. Like my very first job, I worked for Willett's.
I
bagged groceries for a summer before that.
That counts.
At a grocery store.
Oh, that's a great start in life.
Yeah, right?
In
yeah, I know.
That was my first job in a grocery store.
Like 13 or something. Okay. So,
yeah, I was
maybe
not able to drive.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then I worked for Willett's. And then I randomly met a woman when I was in my 20s that said she went to the CIA, the Culinary Institute of America, and I came home and I said, and I said, Mom, I'm going to go there. And I don't know why. Maybe I was like 19 and then I just did it, I guess. Yeah. Just kind of didn't have another plan and stuck with what I liked.
So did you have to know anything before you went there or did they just take anyone off the street?
No, you had to do 6 months in the industry, but nobody will hire you if you don't have any.
Yeah.
So it was a difficult little stint there. So I remember going around the cities and like I went to Comp Yellow and I went to all the big wig, things and everybody was like, no, you could maybe wash dishes. And then I ended up at TGI Fridays.
Perfect.
Only female line cook. Yeah. This is like, 1999?
Right.
Only female line cook and only American or English-speaking line cook. And I worked the saute, you know.
Yeah.
Not a lot of real cooking happening there.
Right. Yeah.
There's
right.
some.
But yeah, enough that you got a taste of what you're going to do. Yeah.
Requirements fulfilled.
Exactly, right.
Well, you had some kitchen experience.
I just think it's funny to be like a 19-year-old Edina girl who's been like, I'm going to work the line at TGI Fridays.
Yes.
So excited about it, but I did it.
And yeah.
I liked it a lot and went to culinary school. And from there, I went to, you had to do like an externship. I went to Big Sky, Montana.
Oh, wow.
Ooh.
Yeah, and I worked out in there. They had like a, that
it's
was
an externship.
Like, yeah. It's like internship, but for some reason they call
but
it.
But in fucking restaurants, they call it extern.
Yeah, apparently.
Just to be different.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
I think so.
Weird,
come in and do a stage. That's basically work for free.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, no, I think I got paid like $2 an hour.
Yeah.
But it was funny because all my jobs are a little bit strange in the way that I started. If I was just in charge of the smoothie station where I like blended smoothies,
right.
And then like within a few weeks the head chef went to like an insane asylum and then there's nobody there and I was like the only one who wasn't there just to ski.
Right, exactly. They're like,
I'll do it.
She's on the way to an insane asylum.
Yeah. Right?
No, that's awesome.
I know, so I just was the only one willing to do it.
Nice.
I love it.
So I feel like that's the universe taking care of you.
Yeah, exactly.
You were in the
like,
right
you know
place
what?
At the right
know,
time with
like,
the right
no
skills
smoothies.
Saying yes.
I'll just run the whole kitchen.
Yes,
how
yes,
about
I will.
Now you do it all.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
I got that. Have you had one of my smoothies?
Yeah.
Come on.
Obviously, you see the talent.
Yep.
I understand. You know what
Nobody
else I can do without
works this blender,
you know,
like I do.
Exactly, right?
Yeah. I have a stupid story about something like that.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what this is about. Yeah. So anyway, but no, when Kate and I, now he's looking at me, he's giving me the eyes like, you can't tell stories.
You can, but it's just...
When Kate, it's just we got a guest and we got to go.
Yeah, exactly.
No, when Kate and I, we worked at a resort in, we helped open a resort in Azerbaijan.
Yeah.
This was
nice.
In 2004.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it was a bunch of, they wanted it Western style, so they brought expats over.
Yeah.
You know, they brought Americans over. And we were like, oh, and they were talking up this chef. And I forget, Chef Bob or whatever.
Right.
His wife.
Sure, he's a good guy.
And Kate and I had both worked at Filio.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, and I'd been in restaurants and stuff. And we're like, oh, chef better be great, right? No. This guy had won a local, regional, whatever, barbecue competition.
I thought you were going to say chili cook-off.
96
yeah,
or something.
Exactly.
May as well have been.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't quite that good.
It wasn't even that good. He didn't even have to do vegetables.
Right. Right.
Just a slam of meat on a grill, and we're
wow.
like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
But...
yeah,
but
I'm
so
sure a lot of people thought
shepping.
That about me.
Yeah.
But that day that I was like, I guess I'll step in.
That's what happens. They're like, well, should we put the smoothie gal?
Exactly.
She's here.
Yeah.
At least we know we'll still have smoothies.
I heard she sauteed a few things once.
Yeah. But the weird thing is, if it snowed, I wouldn't have any cooks. They would all go skiing or snowboarding.
Like, I quit for the day.
And I'd have like a 200-person wedding, and I'd be like,
I need some help.
I get why he went to an insane asylum. Like,
everyone's getting ramen.
Right.
Well, that's what drove me to it, huh?
Exactly.
All right.
Like, I'd be all by myself.
I mean, the snow will still be there after your shift.
Mm-hmm.
It's not melting.
I went to the head of the whole resort and was like, nobody works on snow days. He's like, oh, well, why would they?
He's like, you're not helping.
Like, because there's a 200-person wedding,
exactly.
And I am
we're
brand
still
new.
Doing stuff.
Because we're trying to run a fucking business. Not just ski.
So if you told me when I did this job you didn't need sales or to make money, it would have made it a lot easier.
Yeah, exactly.
And does that then give you license to put a note on the door? Hey, sorry about the whole wedding thing, but it snowed.
It snowed.
Right.
It was your choice.
Right. I was more like, sorry about the quality of the wedding. I got paid $2 an hour and I was alone.
Right, I was alone. So ramen for everyone.
Exactly. Yeah.
Did you do okay, though?
I think I did okay. I mean, looking back on it.
Talk
I
about a
worked,
learning experience.
Yeah, I just worked a lot.
Trial
That's
by
like kind
fire.
Of my trial by fire is kind of my thing. I feel like I just kind of work until I figure it out.
Yeah.
So that's what I did.
Yeah.
So.
Obviously, you figured it out.
Yeah, yeah. So
those
I did
are
that.
Good survival skills.
Yeah.
Okay, so Montana, that gets us through 2001.
Something like that, yep. Then I came back and I worked for Nordstrom Restaurants, and I went around and opened them like around the country for them, and they have like a really good culinary program.
Yeah,
they actually like care about food and where it came from, and
all the consistency.
If you can find them, they're kind of hidden inside the Nordstroms, but they're good. That's good stuff there. So I worked for them and opened restaurants, and then one day just got a job at Lucia's in Uptown.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and that was kind of where things really kind of began for me, because she's
in the kitchen still?
I did not. I actually took a job in the front of the house, but I did a lot of, like, when we did caterings and things, I cooked. So I would jump back and forth there.
Yeah. So do you consider yourself like a chef? Is that your thing?
Well,
you know, like,
so the opening of this restaurant was my grand return to the kitchen in my head.
Nice.
Right.
Nice.
Like,
right.
I was just going to be like, oh, here comes Ted. I made him a special sandwich. Like, mm-hmm. I had... like naive thoughts about opening a restaurant. I thought it would be
business ownership is tough.
Yeah, I thought it would be like really hands-on for me in the kitchen, and it's not as much so. Mm-hmm. Which means we're busy, which is good.
Yeah, that is good. Yeah.
But it's still not exactly what you thought it was going to
be.
And
yeah.
You kind of change to go with the flow and keep swimming in the stream.
Yeah, my friend said, like, at opening day, I called my friend up. She has a food truck in New Orleans, and I called her up to help. So it was, like, the two of us on the line the very first day, and I had, like, three tongs and, like, two bowls.
You're like, oh, shit, I gotta go buy some stuff.
She was like, you're really busy for this much equipment. You need to go
shopping. Holy crap.
Like, do you realize bowls are only $5?
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
$5 a piece. Get
Can I
one.
Use the bowl now? I have another salad on order.
Yep.
Do you
hold
know
on.
Where
hey,
restaurant
can we hold
supply
off?
Is?
We don't have any
I know. So it got real pretty quick.
Yeah.
But yeah. Nice. So then luckily I had hired Wilson and he kind of jumped in and I kind of stepped away and just started overseeing everything. And so I don't spend that much time in the kitchen anymore, unfortunately. But
yeah.
But if it works, it works.
It works. Yeah, yeah. I agree.
I mean, isn't part of like traditional formal chef school also business training?
Absolutely.
To learn how to run
yeah.
a kitchen?
Absolutely. Yeah. 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 It's just you think when you're going to grow up and you're going to own a restaurant and you're going to be a chef, you're not going to spend like that much time on the computer, but I find myself on the computer quite a bit.
Has anyone else found that as you get older, like you spend way more time on the computer than you ever thought would be necessary?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, yeah.
Like, why do I have to do all this shit?
Why? Yes. Can someone else
do this?
Why am I doing it?
And I can barely spell, so that's the whole issue. I'm a chef.
They do it for
exactly.
I'm a chef.
Yeah. We're not required to spell.
Yes. Construction and kitchens are like the two places that if you've completely bombed out in life in every other way,
exactly.
you can make a living.
Yeah,
exactly.
You're always good there.
You may not
you're
be a good living, but
you're always good. There will always be a place
for
you.
That was my plan.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know.
Yeah. So, but here we are.
Are your parents
things
proud?
Are going good. My parents are proud. My dad
wow.
was the. I was
you
like,
just
we
answered.
Should.
Yeah,
that
was like, hell yeah.
Well, I was about to be like, should we turn this off for this? My dad was literally the worst customer that we had for the first 2 months. I had to kick him out.
Yeah.
Was
like,
he there
go
every day?
Away.
He was there every day, but he was not.
He's
he
like baby apple.
Their like love is to like be really mean to me.
Oh,
okay. So they're from
the
same family.
Mean to me?
Yeah.
I know.
My kids are like, fuck, I totally understand that.
I know. Yeah. It's like, so the rest of the world doesn't hurt my feelings. They're going to do it first.
Nice.
So my dad, I remember it was like a snowy day and everybody's waiting outside for their takeout. We've only been open like 3 weeks and we're really busy. And he's standing out on the sidewalk going, is anyone's food taking too long? Mine's taking way too long. Does anyone want a show of hands who thinks their food should be ready? And I'm like, Dad, you gotta go away.
You are done.
Like, you're dead.
Snap his picture. You're now 86.
Yeah. I 86'd him. I was like, he's gotta
really
go.
Mean, Dad.
I know.
That's sweet and mean.
Know.
I mean, I'm sure he meant well, but
he like goes table to table. Like he's like, I'm not like super social, and as a front of the house manager, I'm not like at every table. But he goes table to table, and he'll be like, "Did you get a coffee refill? Is yours hot enough? Because mine wasn't." I'm like,
so he's like sowing the seed.
Yeah,
I mean, you almost need to hire him and solve that problem.
Yeah. No way, that would be horrible,
right?
Well, you can, but he has to start dishwashing. I mean,
right.
He has to work his way up.
No,
could you ask him to do it in reverse?
Yeah,
because if you plant the seed, if you're like, wasn't that coffee nice and hot?
God,
you got
nice
as much
hot.
As you wanted, right?
Right.
Yeah. People are like, you're right, I did.
Yeah,
yeah,
okay,
exactly. Exactly. Help me out, Dad.
Yeah, like, I will pay you to do it the opposite
right.
way of what you're doing, Dad.
And my mom was convinced nobody was going to come to the restaurant because Trader Joe's sells wine for cheaper. She said,
that was
I asked
the rationale.
All my friends,
okay.
and they're not going to come because they can get it cheaper at Trader Joe's. I was like,
then they should stay there.
Stay home. You guys
should
stay home till things even out around here.
Pretty confident you're not my target audience.
Exactly.
You're good.
Exactly.
That's really silly.
I know. It's so dumb.
I'm like, you know, when you've worked in restaurants and I bartended a little bit and stuff, but like I know that the bottle of wine that I've got four glasses that come out of this bottle.
Yeah.
And I know that I can go get that bottle for $6.99.
Yeah.
And then I'm sitting in front of someone, I'm like, boop, boop. And then like, there's $14.
You know?
Yeah, but
like,
somebody else poured it.
They're like, thank you so much because you know what? That $7 I would have spent at home and sat there, it's like not worth it. I want to come here and get my wine.
Experience.
Exactly.
That's
right.
I always love that. People are like, why is so much? I'm like, okay, tell you what. Pay for your bills, pay for your house, pay for they make a meal. Now that's how I'm doing it.
Exactly.
Right.
Not all this is free.
Right. Exactly.
I've never thought of that.
Oh, exactly.
And, like, you know, and I brought you the food and drinks to your table. It's ready for you to put in your mouth.
I've actually used that before. People are like, you know, I could make this at home. And look at me go, no, you couldn't.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, come on, let's be honest.
That's
you could be home making it. No, you cannot.
By the way, guess who's cleaning up your table?
Yeah,
exactly.
Dishes, now you are show me.
Get out and tip. Make sure
you
I always feel like it costs more money
Dad.
To eat at home these days.
It does.
I know.
It is
I don't
incredibly
know. I'm probably doing
expensive.
It wrong. Like,
no,
I'm
you're
like,
doing it wrong.
No,
like having to chef it up and like add 10 million things.
You can still eat very well at home.
Yeah, but it's expensive when I go home.
I had
to go out.
Two bags of groceries from Cub, primarily produce, but nothing weird. And it was like $91.
Yes. Yeah.
Like, what would be weird?
Okay, so a bottle of canola oil was almost $8.
Yeah.
I'm talking Wesson. Just nothing fancy.
Out of control these days. It's like $140 a case.
We just like, no one gets limes anymore. I don't care.
Yeah.
It's like limes are through the roof. Why want a lime? Well, that's going to be $5. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous. Somebody took over the lime industry.
Yeah. It's a weird world.
It is a weird world.
Well, and we all got used to, like, it's January 15th. Why do these strawberries look like shit?
Yeah.
Because we used to not winter, do strawberries in Minnesota.
Not be able to get
them. Probably shouldn't.
No. Because we're probably ruining the world doing it.
Right. Exactly.
But, you know, we still want our strawberries, I guess. It's just the way things work.
The decadence.
The other the consequence of that is my parents are going to start raising chickens.
Oh.
Ooh, because eggs are also expensive.
Yeah, because that's cheaper.
Yeah. They went to a class. They're building a coop.
Buying the feed, buying the chickens.
But they also live in a part of Minnesota where they have nature trail cams. They have timber wolves. They have coyotes.
So they're the
wildlife. Have bears. I'm like,
they're feeding the wildlife.
How are you guys?
It's weasels they have to worry about. They're all over
I mean,
the
or hawks or eagles or, I mean, pick a predator at that point. Yeah. Like, you're lucky if you get one egg out of this thing, but I'm happy you're happy.
Good luck.
I mean, if they could admit to themselves maybe that they're just doing it because they think it's cool, but they got to do it. They got to justify it with the
how
eggs
did that become the new trend?
Yeah. Raising eggs?
Yeah, raising eggs. It's like, you know, we're what? I'm just going to have my own roost now. Like,
everyone's doing it.
Okay. It really is.
Everyone's doing it.
Yeah. Well.
Why not?
I mean, it is like 10 bucks a dozen or whatever.
I can't wait to get some free eggs.
But you're right. It's not cheaper to raise your own.
No.
It's like you go buy a tomato plant. It's kind of like, by the time I'm done, 2 months later. Yeah, it's like, okay. My time, everything I put into it, I could have just bought a tomato.
You should ask your folks and this is why eggs don't make any sense, because we're used to eggs being like $1.60 or $2 or $3 or whatever it is, right? But there's a whole lot that goes into getting that egg made, and at the end of it, there's a farmer who made nothing. Like literally almost nothing on each egg, right? So you should ask them to put all the numbers together. It's like when I go fishing and I bring home 2 pounds of walleye, and it's like, well, that's
$700
a pound by the time I get done.
I caught a bunch of fish. Like, I'm filling the freezer. Like, oh shit, that's expensive.
Right. We're going to have to make some hot dogs to feed the kids.
Yep.
Because you did not bring home enough fish.
Cheese sticks.
Yeah. I will definitely ask my stepdad about the costs going into getting chickens and building a coop and his own personal labor, because my mom will just be in the house bragging about raising chickens.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. I got 12 eggs.
Yep. And next month, we're going to get 12 more.
Yep.
That's great.
So do you raise your own eggs?
No, we do not. And it is expensive.
Yeah.
It'd be expensive. We wouldn't be able to.
Yeah.
I think we did 17 cases at the height of their price that weekend. He was like, I think I have to order 17 cases. And I was like, that's like, I don't even know. It was like 900 eggs or something.
Wow.
Yeah. Right.
1,000 something eggs. I don't even know.
Fortunately, wholesale is less. I mean, like, food service. I'm a little surprised because I had a memorial for a friend and I cooked the food, and I bought chicken, and I was like, in the industrial, like at the big Costco.
Yeah.
Like, it's cheaper than it's $3 a pound for this, and then when you buy it in the big fucking box, it's like $1.50 or $2.
See, sometimes I think Costco's the way to go.
Yeah, it is.
Sometimes. Oh, yeah.
Like, if I had someone just price shopping and could, like, run around, I think Costco could beat it sometimes. Yeah.
Cisco or
I think they just go. It's like the, like, Aldi thing or Trader Joe's, where they go and get the, like, whatever one thing and buy all of it so they get the cheapest price.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
I'm not, like, I don't know how to figure that out.
Yeah, like, no,
I
don't want to spend time.
I don't know. Yeah. Yeah.
Just
got
to click on the buttons yeah. and then send them to me.
Yeah,
you?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Watermelon's a big one because people got buy watermelon at Costco for like $4. And when I get it through Bix, it's $17 a watermelon.
Yeah, you're like,
no shit.
And, like, what? And then yeah. it shows up and it's like a winter watermelon. And you're
it's
just like so depressed.
It's like a shitty watermelon.
Yeah. Oh, cute. Yeah. I can use this as an ornament on
yeah.
something. But
yeah, it's so sad.
I don't know if you can eat it.
Yeah.
I always wondered where, like, we worked at Filio together.
Yeah.
And Filio, at the time we worked there, they had, it was the first time in my life that I had, like, a really super fantastic heirloom tomato salad thing that they had.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. I remember the tomato guy.
I was like, where in the fuck are you buying a tomato that tastes this good? Like, how
was it?
It was Tom, the tomato guy. He had his own garden. He was a hippie. He grew other things besides tomatoes.
Oh, yeah.
Tomatoes are his, I don't want to call them his cover.
Yeah.
But the tomatoes growed high and the other stuff growed sideways.
Sure, yeah.
And he grew heirloom tomatoes because it helped foster the soil.
About.
Oh,
you
and they're
those.
Amazing.
Yeah.
So
he would show up. The BLT at Filio's was one of my favorite things ever, too.
Yeah.
That probably had Tom's tomatoes.
He would show up. He would show up at the back door like, hey, they're in season now. We're like, cool.
Yeah.
Tomatoes? Okay.
Yeah. I get where he's going with
this. Yeah.
It's subtle. It's right there.
But so I wonder when you get your food for Heather's, is it easier to just get it from Sysco, US Food, and Bix?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, we have a couple small farmers, but that do mostly like proteins. But like we have a poultry farmer and then a pig farmer. But I mean, I'd love to have more farmers. I think that because
I'm not
we opened
to call
at
you
a
out or anything.
No. We just opened at a weird time like there was everybody stopped talking to you. You know,
it's
you're
true.
Like,
yeah.
you're like, can I even get my US Foods? Is anyone around?
Is there anyone?
It's like
to
crickets
bring it?
Everywhere.
Yeah, I mean,
so
I spent like 6 months in my garage sewing masks.
I know.
I really did.
I know my friends would say, can we have a Zoom phone call?
I forgot about masks. I'm like, what kind of like? Okay.
No, I mean the hospital had run out. Everyone in my family was in the healthcare field, and I'm like. Fuck, I'll sit here and sew masks and drink brandy and cry about the world coming to an end.
I know. My friends would be like, can we have a Zoom call? I haven't seen anyone in 3 months. And I was like, well, I saw
Zoom
like 100 people every day for the last 3 days.
Yeah, exactly.
I say I never had COVID. Yeah. I say I must have microdosed daily some COVID.
Yeah.
But I never, ever quarantined even for a day.
You're aware of because you could have been
asymptomatic. Or I could have been asymptomatic. Yeah. But I just say I was like right there in the trenches.
That's
of
the
it.
Universe taking care of you.
See, there you go.
Right there.
I like
it's
the universe.
Taste.
Yeah.
It's been doing all right.
I mean, you're in that kitchen, you're doing all this stuff. Like, maybe the universe just knew, like,
we got to keep this one going.
We'll let her slide.
Let him go.
We got to keep this one going.
You get a pass.
I mean, have you tasted the food?
Yeah. It's like, hey, come on.
Thank you. That's so nice.
It's pretty sweet, huh?
Yeah.
All right. No, I mean it, though. It's really because. There's a lot of places that get sort of hyped, and then I go to them, and I'm like, meh.
You're like,
you know,
no.
That's
right.
All
yeah.
I get it. It's fine. But, like, can we do better? And your place, I was like, meh. Whoa, wait a minute. This is really good.
I know.
It's different.
We do, like, basic stuff really good. We sit, we eat a lot of Reubens to make a good Reuben, you know? Like, we talk a lot about it taste it.
Yeah, that's what that's the impression I got was whoever's making this for me actually cares whether this is done the right way or not. Like, it came out, whatever. It all came out right, you know?
Yeah, I have a really good staff. It's funny because they all work at a different place. I won't name that place, but...
Hell
like
no,
the day place, they all get together and go to the night place. So they're like thick as thieves. They're family. They would, you know, take care of each other.
Well, that must make it
life
a fun place.
It's still the same.
Yeah.
Yep. Like behind that's the great. Scenes for the employees, that's a fun place to work then.
Yeah. They're family meal every day and they're happy for the most part.
Famous restaurant movie where they, what am I trying to think of? Where like, where they show the, you know, like, what happens after work and I can't remember. It's like
a party?
It's a movie about restaurant life. It's not even that
more
good.
More than one. Waiting?
Yeah. That waiting? One's like a gross one.
Yeah, that one is
like
a gross
dark side of the restaurant
comedy.
I don't know. I don't think that's it.
You're gonna have to do better.
I never do
fact
better.
We actually don't have like the party scene though.
No, because you're daytime.
It's professionals
Well, we're there till like 8, but because of the pandemic, everybody wanted to go home immediately because they were all like scared of each other, though they spent 9 hours standing next to each other.
Kids.
Yeah. I know. Everybody would just go. And I was like, okay, that's cool.
It was
cool.
A free for all.
It was party every fucking night. You remember that?
I probably was there not working there. Staying after hours. Yes. I loved
everybody
Filio.
Was there.
Yeah, well,
loved
and,
it.
Well, actually, we go up to the Moose, but
well, or that one Aura or something, the one down the hall.
Yeah.
Like that
somehow was open till 5 a.m. every night.
Wow. Yeah.
Like, how does this happen in Minneapolis?
Yeah,
like,
it was amazing. I loved it.
They're just
going to
keep serving me drinks.
Nobody
all night.
Stopped them.
Yeah. I know, it was great.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we should take a little break. Right. Okay.
We'll come back.
Should we?
Yeah.
Sure.
I think we should come back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we're going to come back.
Oh, yeah.
That's all about taking a break.
Oh, yeah, we should do that, too.
Okay, cool.
Thanks. Save the world, it could be up to you. Wait a second,
wait a minute, and we're through. Kinetic Legacy is the company that powers the Joe Contractor app. Their unique platform blends the good parts of social tech with their one-of-a-kind data organizing system, giving communities large and small a safe, private space to stay connected and to keep information and memories organized. If you and your community have a shared purpose or passion and are looking for a better way to stay connected, contact Kinetic Legacy today at kineticlegacy.us. Find out how groups from contractors to campers, tribal communities, unions, and alumni organizations are finding their way to meaningful new spaces in this increasingly digital world. Again, that's kineticlegacy.us. Reeder Home Restorations is a Minnesota-based full-service residential general contracting company specializing in the repair and painting of historic homes. Whether your home needs repairs, painting, or remodeling, Reeder Home Restorations has got you covered. We understand that every home, client, and project is unique. At Reeder Home Restorations, we pledge to give you a long-lasting product while paying close attention to client questions and concerns. Check us out at www.readerhomerestorations.com. That's Reeder, spelled with two E's, homerestorations.com. Wonder Woman Construction is a Minneapolis-based, woman-owned residential and commercial construction and electrical company. Lori and her team pride themselves on their commitment to long-term green and sustainable building practices, and they apply their deep understanding of building science to each project they take on. They are dedicated to the complete satisfaction of every client. One more thing that you absolutely cannot miss about Wonder Woman Construction is the fact that every employee loves what they do and truly enjoys working with each other. The best projects are those that are done by happy people. And Wonder Woman Construction is full of happy people. Visit WonderWomanConstruction.com to get started on your happiest project ever. Save the world, it could be up to you. Wait a
second, wait a minute, and we're through. Good job, Sam.
Thank you. I run the controls. It's kind of like a special thing that I'm good at.
So you're special.
I push the button.
Yep.
Makes it
well, you do more than that. You do the editing. You do.
That's true.
You always remember to take the picture at the end.
I'm generally the one who remembers that.
I have some hand in helping remember take a picture.
You're the only one that remembers to take a picture. We neither. Yeah.
Mark does nothing.
I don't.
To be fair,
really
you actually.
That's not true. He set all of this up.
I moved some chairs, Sam.
He actually even. And said, I'm going to go downstairs and set up, and I watched him walk away.
Yep,
and
said, you
help.
Should do that.
Did not even offer to help.
Good job, buddy.
Yep, I'll be right here.
That is good. So after today's show, I'm gonna record a small appeal to people and start talking about the future of what we're doing here. So if I'm not going to subject you to it during the middle of the show, but if you're listening to the show, you've made it this far, you actually enjoy this stuff. I
That's
swear
right.
so much lately. I can't stop
yeah,
it.
Watch your effing mouth.
I can't stop. I don't know why. If you're enjoying this stuff, I'll have a little message for you at the end of the show.
Ooh, foreshadowing.
Stay tuned.
Dun, dun,
what do we think
dun.
About that? Yeah.
I bet it's going to be awesome.
It's going to be, please help us.
Yeah.
Who wants to sponsor us? Pay for something.
Well,
we do this for free.
No.
No, it won't be that.
No.
It'll be something along those
it'll
lines.
It'll be a message to Malort. Please sponsor us.
Why, Malort, have you not I mean,
we've been trashing you for how many shows?
You know what Malort is?
I don't.
You don't. You really are from Edina.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's very innocent.
It's a disease from Chicago.
it's like the world's worst liqueur or something.
Oh, yeah. No.
Yep.
Oh, they're trying to infiltrate because they've ran out of people in Chicago who've tried it.
Yep. It's one of those things that, like, if you know people from Chicago and you go to Chicago and you're in any local Chicago bar, dive bar specifically, kind of. Mm. But they're going to be like, let's do some Malort. Like, let's take a shot of Malort.
And you're just like, to be a dick.
Yeah, you're like, okay, great.
It's like Fernet or whatever.
It's not
people,
even...
People really like Fernet.
Yeah, it doesn't
though,
taste...
So really
it doesn't taste that good.
Oh, it doesn't taste that good. Oh.
And, oh, no. Yeah. It's there's a lot of ways to describe it. I have my personal favorite is something like orange peels and burnt plastic.
Yeah.
And burnt plastic,
oddly enough, spot on.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Not an exaggeration.
Nope. So, and oddly enough, they haven't said, hey, you know what?
Them.
We want to be part of you.
Yeah. We did a whole episode.
We did a whole episode.
Cordy Malort. And we didn't talk the whole time about it, but Cordy Malort.
Did you drink it the whole time?
Oh,
no,
God.
I wouldn't touch it.
No.
Oh, no.
Not my worst.
That could have gotten really interesting by the end.
We want to help spread the word.
We want them to support us.
It's more like a PSA warning.
We're looking for like $50
from Malort. That's
what we're thinking. Or a bottle.
Give us money.
Get a bottle.
Yeah, or we'll, otherwise, we're not going to stop talking about how. Yeah.
I have had brewers and distillers and stuff on the show, and I'm always like, what's if up? You're coming on the show, like, better
what's
bring
up?
Us something. Did you bring us any food, Heather?
I
did. What the fuck?
That is a mean thing to say to her right now.
You'd rather have beer than all the like, food that's ever
wow.
I know. Yeah. These two are getting
Kieran
all mad at
me. Brought us a bottle of Red Fox.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes
yeah, but he has one with him at all times.
Well,
that's really not that impressive.
Yeah, but
yeah.
I still have a little
he's
left
so
in
wonderful.
That bottle.
I love Kieran.
Yeah. He's great.
He really is.
He hasn't gotten back to me lately. I've been
after that last episode.
It's the Irish season.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure he hasn't had anything else going on the last week.
Plus, all I'm doing is bugging him about this business idea I've got. Actually, a business idea that could help get you more local farmers' produce and
stuff.
Oh,
I like that.
Though. Yeah,
okay.
So I really do have a solid idea. Yeah. And I really... Kieran's a lovely man, and he doesn't have to get back to me.
Like, no, he's like,
I'm pretty unimportant.
Yeah.
But I'm calling you out, Kieran.
He'll eventually...
I mean,
come
he's only
around.
Been on the show, what, two, three times?
Yeah, two or three times.
Okay.
That's well, we used to have, work across the street from the food building, and I really love what he's done with all of them.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. They have good food, too.
They have great food.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. It's fun. It's a fun place to be.
So.
Actually, the cheesemaker from the Alamar Cheese is a waitress at Heather's now.
Oh, very cool.
No shit.
Yeah,
well, that's
nice.
Great.
Yeah. She said it's really, really hard work to be a cheesemaker.
I bet.
I believe
she's
taking
that.
A break, even though it's her family business.
Right. I believe that.
Is her last name Alamar?
It is not. No.
Just curious.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's
yours
what she was
is...
working
there.
No,
Asbury. Like raspberry, but with a
Asbury.
Like think with an AZ, even though it's AS. Asbury.
The guy that can't remember names knew
you
it.
You did it.
Yeah.
You did it. See, I told you I'm really bad at
I
this.
Thought you were having a seizure.
It's all right.
When I try and remember people's names, it is like a
seizure. It's pretty much the same thing.
It's very similar.
Yes.
Oh, my brain just didn't do it. So you grew up in Edina.
Yep.
Lived in Minneapolis. This is your first. Is this your first business that you've ever owned?
I've always secretly catered. Like, no matter what job I've ever had, I kind of had
secretly?
My own. Like, well, because I've never like did the work to get licensed and stuff.
Right, exactly.
Like,
hey, can you come in Thursday?
No,
I have plans.
But like, you know, and sometimes I'm my motto in life is to say yes to pretty much everything.
Yeah.
So that people would be like, oh, I have a 200 person thing. And I'd be just literally me and be like, here we go.
Okay.
And I'd be like, Mom, I need to borrow some tables for my living room.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And I just cater like I've always done that. So, yeah, so I would say that that was my first thing I did, which I had little homemade business cards that my dad made.
Did you
made
learn this?
The one time your dad helped you?
The one time my dad helped me.
I'll make you these business cards.
Right.
And then I'm going to
he probably charged me double.
Yeah. Right, exactly.
Then I'm moving straight into heckler.
Like, you don't need enough, so you're going to have to pay more.
It sounds like you probably have a decent relationship with him, though, if you can give him that much shit. But you know he's like, nah, he's 85. He's not listening
to the show. No, you could say it right to his face. Yeah. I'd be like, Dad, I think you charged me double. He'd be like, well, there wasn't enough cards to justify the regular price. I had to drive all the way there.
It was special ink. Yeah. You got a good deal.
Exactly.
Did you learn this skill, this ability to say, feed 200 people by yourself with using your own equipment at the time that you had your stint making smoothies that then turned into you being the only employee?
That was the beginning of it.
And then, that how you learned that?
I think so. And then, I went and worked for Lucia when I was there. I just wanted to cater. I kind of wanted to do the more private chef thing with her. So we did a lot of in-home dinners where we'd actually cook and plate it. And that was really fun. That's kind of like the catering that you think of that you want to do. But then everybody needs a large party at some point in their life. And then you do those too. Yeah. And it's great. Yeah. So I've always done that. I went and worked after Lucia's because unfortunately that she closed.
That's a business, but that's not a real business.
Business, you mean? Yeah. My secret.
Only
secret
because there's a lot more that goes into a real business. Like owning or not renting the building or whatever. All the different things.
Yeah, but it's fun to have a side hustle.
No, it's a good start.
It was a pretty strong side hustle.
It's a good start, and I love that you did it. But is this the first one that was where you're...
Here we go.
Do you have other investors?
I do have other investors. Yeah. I do have to say I would not have named it Heather's had it not been for them. I would come every day with a new name and they'd all shoot me down. Yeah. Come the next day being and then what about this name? And they'd all be like, nope, it's Heather's. And I was darn it.
Yeah, no, I get
that. At one point in time, Kaluna is a restaurant now, a very wonderful restaurant in Minneapolis, Kaluna, but it was the botanical name for the plant Heather. Oh. So I was trying to sell everybody on Kaluna.
You had it first.
That doesn't make sense for what we're going to do. And so I caved, and I think it was a really smart decision.
It worked out well.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, you put your name on it, there's some love and care in there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
That is for sure.
And they believe in you. Otherwise, they would not keep every day coming back saying, that's a good idea. No, we're calling in Heather's. Throw those other ideas away.
That's nice. Yeah.
I think so. There's universe taking care of you again.
I love this.
See?
I do say that a lot. I do say that a lot. I'm like, something about the universe likes this little building.
And the neighborhood needed it, too.
They did, yeah.
The building was such a cool little...
Yeah. Was it Mario's or something?
It was Mario's. So it was like a grocer, I guess, at one point in time. And then it was Mario's Pizza, and it was a little family-owned pizza joint. Mm-hmm. And everybody in the neighborhood says that they can remember that the husband and wife would, yell at you, yell at each other. You go in, and you'd be like, I'm going to have the chocolate cake. And she'd be like, you're having this. And she'd, give you a raspberry cake and, send you on your way.
But I'm allergic to raspberries. Too bad.
It was, really good food. So they were just from Italy and yelling at you in Italian.
And that had the little back area that's kind of
I don't think they ever did anything out there.
But they never did anything. It was always there.
Yeah. I have pictures of me and the weeds are taller than me.
Yeah.
And then there's a dilapidated little building out back.
It was such a cute little building.
I know.
That needed a life.
Yep. I know. It was...
I really thought about buying it at one point with my brother-in-law and putting a restaurant in there.
Yeah. I think that...
Well, you know what? Failed. No
it
offense.
It would have been Sam's.
No offense. I think all of us sitting here are happy you didn't.
Oh, right.
Oh, no. I completely agree.
I think I was the only one naive enough to go through with it because a lot of people looked at the space and I was like, sure, I don't know what we're doing.
Oh, I sent someone a letter.
Yeah.
I did. Yeah. I looked up the ownership. Who owns this building in public records? And I sent them a letter and I'm like, look, we're serious. We'd love to, But I'm glad you did. Really glad you did.
The building would basically fall apart every time we tried to do any, we had to put a new roof on it.
And look at it wrong and a little bit more crumbles off.
They found a bunch of heroin in the walls.
Oh my God.
So the guy you wrote the letter to might not have been totally with it.
He's like, wow.
He's like, Sam going to give me money?
Once you get to the west wall, I'm going to need some cash.
That's my retirement plan.
Yep. I know.
Yeah. Actually, it wasn't him. It was the cooks.
Yep.
Because the cooks in the 80s, everyone knows.
Yeah.
You did drugs, and every time a new cook would come in, they'd be like, cool, what's the name of your band?
Yeah.
I'd be like, oh, cool. That sounds good.
Well, this week, the band name
yeah,
is.
Exactly. Yeah. Everybody was in
funny.
A band.
That's great.
Yeah. So you managed to convince some people who support you
yeah.
that mm-hmm. you should open up a restaurant, and yeah. you did it, and it all worked out so far.
So far, so good. Yeah.
I mean, and if you got through that first part.
The first part was very hard.
Yeah, it's like, jeez.
Well, restaurants are funny, too, because, like, I mean, my understanding of how restaurants work, and construction is not, I did owned a construction company for a long time. Anyway, not dissimilar in certain ways. Like, you could be going along fine, and if something doesn't work out for just a short period of time, it's like,
done.
It's over, you know.
Yeah.
Not just...
No, but congratulations so far.
Oh, that's really shitty. Yeah. I didn't mean
it's
it
okay.
that way.
Every day
it's a
I'm
house
scared.
Of cards. Good luck.
you've pulled off the impossible for a while.
Yeah.
I suspect that could.
Yeah exactly. No, at any moment.
That's right. But good restaurants that are well run that like they also can blossom into these much larger things.
Yeah.
And and you know. We don't, for whatever reason, we haven't had very many restaurant people on. I've invited a lot of restaurant people, but they haven't come in over the years.
They're usually
too busy working.
They are busy working.
But they're self-promoters, but they're different, too. Like, the musicians are like, yes, of course they'll come in, because every musician just wants to talk about themselves and how life is going. And their band.
I mean, except for the ones we've had on have been amazing.
No, they have been amazing. We love them. I absolutely love them. And I will continue to get musicians, because I love musicians. But... restaurant, you know, let's say we've had one other chef, I think.
Yeah.
Anyway, Brian Ingram from over in St. Paul.
Yep. And stuff.
Hope Restaurants?
Yep. Yeah. Hope anyway, and Apostle. Yeah. And,
but, like, are you thinking that you're going to expand this into something else, or are you thinking that
Heather's just holding on to your life
thing?
Like, oh, my God.
Dear life. No, I think I love to be challenged in life, and I love... you know, that it is a very tiny restaurant. If you really think about it, it's like we have this giant tent out back, which like triples our seating, but that was never really part of the plan for the winters. And I actually don't know how we would have made it through any winters without that giant tent, because it's like 30 seats inside. I don't know. I really had the idea that it was going to be just a little tiny restaurant and have to just pay the bills. And, so I do want to expand. I do want to do something else. I do want to keep the ball rolling and be challenged. And catering seems to be this thing that I have a secret catering company, but it's licensed in my basement of the restaurant.
Yeah, now it's okay. Now
did you name it the secret catering company?
Yes. Sure.
Yeah. On the side, kind of on the side
name.
Catering.
I know. So it's just, that seems to be going really well and very busy. And I spent a lot of my energy. I shifted it kind of from, you know, the kitchen and getting it all going to the front of the house and making sure that was going well. And now I'm kind of doing this little
is this
selling
the kind
this
of
catering
secret
thing.
Catering company that might come to someone's house and cook dinner for them and their entire family?
And their
family?
Entire family? Yes, I may have done that before.
Oh,
you
that's actually how I...
sneaky host.
Yes.
I know. It
when
was
they
fun.
Told me, so I had already been a fan of Heather's.
Yeah, that was a fun party.
Wait,
and
I wasn't
and
there.
Never met you. No.
Yeah.
And
I don't remember that.
Thanks for picking
I'm
up
sorry.
On that, Kate.
I'm sorry I don't invite you to my wife's.
It's because I live on the other side of the river.
Oh, wait, your wife's family? Oh, I know who to talk to now.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah,
fair
yeah.
enough.
My wife's family's get-togethers that they plan.
Yeah.
That I didn't
You're
know.
Just happy to be
a
involved
convenient
here.
Convenient excuse.
No,
but yeah. I'm listening.
Whatever, you two. I got there, and they're like, oh, yeah, Heather's is catering it or whatever, and I'm like, oh, that's cool. And then I walked into the kitchen. I'm like, no, you mean they're in the kitchen cooking? Like,
yeah, they're not catering.
Catering.
That's different.
I mean, you know,
it is. It's
in
different.
Other people's understanding, they would think that's catering.
Yeah,
yeah, no.
But I'm like, no, they're fucking that in your it. Kitchen cooking my food tonight. And then I met you, and I'm like, you're the actual Heather.
Yeah,
yeah.
And it was.
That's that was cool. Maybe the first time I felt like anyone knew who I was. Because
nice.
I spent so much time behind the scenes, and I don't like. You know, you do all the rigmarole every day, and you file the paperwork, and you take pictures of invoices, and you're doing all this stuff. And then I went there, and then you come around the corner, and you're like, oh, my gosh, Heather. And then your other family, oh, Heather. And everyone. And then I think it was your mother-in-law walked up to me, and she was like, does everyone at this party know you? Nice. I don't know. It feels like it.
Well, because that party
was so great.
Jay would have been there, and he was the one who was considering the building purchase. He's like, Jill, we'll figure something out. I'll help you. We'll work on it.
Yeah, it was a fun party.
It would have never worked out. It would never have worked out.
We're all very happy it worked out the way it did.
This was like 10 or 15 years ago, too. Like, yeah. I was early on.
He wasn't moving yet, the guy in the basement.
Oh, not
yet.
Well, he had a stash.
Exactly. He's like, I'm good for a while.
As soon as I find that heroin in the wall, I'm out of here. Yeah. But not a minute before.
And didn't and sold.
Took him years to tear the place apart. Find it. Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Poor guy. We shouldn't.
I know. I don't know where he is. Some random person came once and told me he was him. And then what I've known of that man is that he's older. He's in a wheelchair. He's lived a hard life.
Yeah.
And this like 18-year-old kid came and tried to tell me it was him. And I was like, I don't think that adds up.
Like, I'm not buying it.
I don't think you've been on drugs for years.
All right. So you were locked up in county. He told you the story. And
yeah,
now
maybe
you're here.
There you go. There you go. That might actually be right there. But he came with his mother, who supposedly was the sister. I don't know. It was a weird story. But I had some weird things happen in the beginning.
She's like, sorry, we cooked it all.
Yeah, exactly.
You hear him walking or going down the sidewalk like, I thought we were going to get free food out of that store.
Something.
Yeah, right. Well, and it like warms my heart to know that restaurants are still weird, though.
Yeah, they're weird.
Yeah. Like,
right?
It's supposed to be a weird place.
Yeah.
I loved how infinitely weird Uptown was, and it didn't matter. It wasn't just Filio, but you couldn't be
everywhere.
You couldn't be weird enough to stand out amongst the weirdos, and everyone was like, "Well, let's just get along and have a good time then."
Yeah, exactly. All right, let's do this. All I want to do is get through this shift because I got plans.
And
my plans are basically being at this bar.
Being at this bar. Yeah, this one right upstairs.
And that part's sad. That part's sad. Maybe there was too much drinking. But
I don't remember.
Mark has no recollection. It was. Those were fun times.
Yes, absolutely.
So restaurants are still weird, even though the poor kids for 2 years were
same.
Like, no, they were like, I mean, our kids aren't the same these days as they were back then either. They're a lot nicer.
They're nicer and probably smarter
nicer
than
that's
we were.
Good.
They're much nicer.
Oh, that's
they
so great.
They don't weaponize sexuality. No. They don't bullying is not tolerated. It happens.
Yeah.
Right. But
you're ostracized. If you're the one doing it, you've got 20 people coming after you.
When we were kids,
junior high was
kid,
rough.
You had to bully.
Yeah.
Like Kate's shaking her head too. Like you didn't rise to the level of cool unless you were able to bully.
Yeah.
And now it's like, oh, you're a bully? Oh, we think you're down here.
Yeah. You're lesser than. It's kind of like, wow, how'd that happen? I like it.
I like it a lot,
but
too.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, good times.
Yeah. The pandemic, it was weird.
It was.
It was.
Yeah.
Did you stress out the whole time?
Well, customers would actually yell at me about things that were so out of my control. You know, like, I see the cooks in the window, and he stepped within 6 foot of the other one, and I'd get calls all the time from the city saying our cooks were within 5 feet or 6 feet of each other.
It's like, that's...
Yeah, I have one stove.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Yeah, there's no other space for them to go.
Yeah, I don't know what rules you think you're following.
They're each other's bubble.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's all we have.
That's what we said. I was like, we're a bubble now.
You know what? And then go somewhere that you feel comfortable. Yeah. If that's your problem, you don't need to police that.
Yeah.
Well, I think everybody just didn't know what to do. It was back, you know, everybody's washing their groceries.
It was crazy.
Oh, yeah. I remember Lysoling groceries. Oh, absolutely.
I did that one time.
Wiping it all out. Yeah.
I did that one time and I was like, this is stupid.
Yeah, you're like, oh my God.
This is not how science works. I'm never doing this again.
I know, exactly. You're spraying down your bread, your loaf of bread with Lysol. You're like,
I should definitely eat this.
This doesn't seem right. Something about this does not add up.
You're like, and I got chemical poisoning, but that's
exactly.
Yeah, but do you remember
I can't go to the hospital.
when the news was telling us that homeless people had to drink or were drinking Lysol because it was cheap? Do you remember that as a kid?
No.
As a kid? I remember Listerine. I don't remember Lysol.
Yeah
Lysol
maybe it was Listerine.
No, it was definitely Lysol as well.
That they seems cracking, very dangerous.
Cracking open cans. Well, you know, I'm going to be
cans of Lysol. I don't know that they ever sold.
I'm sure.
I think we're going to do a fact check.
I don't know. You can fact check. Here, I'll
no,
excuse
later.
Myself.
We do that later. We do that later. No. We don't check anything on this.
I mean, Listerine, I can understand because that has alcohol content in it, but Lysol, what do you, like,
no, there's take,
maybe
I'm not going to bathe on the outside, but goddamn it, on the inside. Right.
Well, that's it.
Clean.
I smell delicious. I smell wonderful and clean. And I can't see
clean.
Straight.
Right.
Well, it's kind of like anything but clean.
It's kind of like it's an aerosol thing, like maybe, you know, huffing paint, but
maybe
Lysol.
Maybe it's like
huffing
paint. When I fart, it's like a burst of Lysol just out there into the...
I'm a ray of sunshine, no matter where I am. Sounds about right.
Right.
I don't think that's what... Well, I don't want to get in trouble.
Agree
with
to disagree.
Yeah. But I don't think that's what we think of commonly when we think of people without homes is
no.
that they fart Lysol farts.
No.
Like, I'm sorry.
Everything
I said was
down,
wrong in some way.
No.
I didn't mean it that way. I'm sorry. I don't even know what to say. No, I'm embarrassed.
Moving on. No, it's okay.
Yeah, there was something you said that I was going to come back to, but I'll let you two figure out the next line of questioning.
So if you weren't doing this, what would you be doing?
Mm. Me? Oh, Lord.
I love when people ask me that. I'm like, I barely know what I'm doing
exactly.
now.
Exactly. I know. When I worked for Lucia's, that was my end-all, be-all, like, life plan.
Yeah.
And I made it so definitive that I was like, this is all I'll ever do for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
That it kind of screwed me over because you like, should probably have a backup plan.
Nah.
So I should probably think about that.
People with backup plans just don't ever do anything then because they're always like, oh, I got the backup plan.
Why would it... When is there time for a backup anyway? When
I haven't
found any time where you get time back.
Yeah.
It seems like it's only moving marching
right.
towards
very fast. Yeah. Time. Very fast.
Does everyone else feeling that too?
I wanted to deliver pizza and live on a beach, but I kind of missed that chapter of my life.
In Hawaii,
so maybe maybe I could go back to that if things don't work out. I don't know.
Maybe this is easier.
There.
Yeah.
What's your favorite food to make?
Ooh, I like
what's your
that
favorite
question.
Dish?
I love a challenge, so I actually really like to make things I've never made before. I really like trying new things. I don't know. I like to. I'd,
all right.
Like,
well,
the Julia and Julia kind of like getting the book out and doing everything new kind of thing.
Yeah.
That's like more exciting to me than probably preparing the same thing. That's why.
What's the coolest thing you've made in the last week or two?
Oh God, nothing. I sadly don't cook
mac
anymore.
And
it's so sad.
I know.
Macaroni
and cheese.
I know. So I have a fiance now, which is exciting.
Congratulations.
He thought he was hitting the jackpot. And, you know, getting a restaurateur.
She's going
to
cook for me all the time.
Okay, so thought he was hitting the jackpot implies that he did not hit the jackpot.
Yeah.
So was he thinking he hit the jackpot because of how wonderful you are? Or
no,
are you going to
because I have a restaurant and he likes food.
Yeah.
So that worked out.
Right.
But
what
I don't cook anymore.
Well, that's it. It's kind of like, oh, you do your massage therapist. Great.
Yeah.
Right. Wait, I'll never get one?
Yeah.
Oh.
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
Although I will say, and
so the jackpot is not exactly what he thought.
Well, and then I don't even let him come to the restaurant.
Well,
so I was like, well, let's go try a new
restaurant. After what your dad did, that seems safe.
Family's not allowed.
It doesn't matter how good your restaurant is. You can't eat there all the time.
Yeah.
It's just the way it is.
Right? Yeah. Well, and you're off work. You want to be off work.
Yeah.
You know?
Like
I love going out to eat. We have great restaurants in the city.
Yes.
We do.
I am personally capable of building you a house. You know,
that's awesome.
Whatever. Yeah, it is or it isn't. Because I might
sounds
fuck it
like
up.
Sounds like a
win. Yeah.
No,
I'll get it done.
Still do it.
Yeah. But that doesn't mean that I want to come home from doing
and
that
make
stuff
a birdhouse.
And build my house.
Right.
You know, so
I know. It's the whole saying, chef's eat McDonald's or whatever, you know?
Yeah.
Because it's like you get done and you're
100%
kind of just done.
Yeah.
And I don't necessarily cook anymore at work, but it's just the constant conversation about food.
Yeah.
I mean, I like food a lot. I talk about food. I think about food. We talk about menus. We talk about recipes. So, unfortunately, he thought, oh, my gosh, I'm never going to eat better in my life. And we just go out to eat a lot. Which
he does.
I pick good restaurants.
Yeah, there you go. So it worked.
But do other people around town know you?
I don't know.
I mean, do you go in, like when I go with this guy and his wife?
Oh.
Right? It's hey, Mark. Yeah. Hey, Brenda.
That's cool. I love
get the
that.
Table. And then, oh, you guys, oh, we comped half your meal.
Or like, it doesn't happen every time.
I said every time I go out with you guys.
All right, fair enough.
All right. Yeah. Like, that seems to have cast a
pretty
wide net
over the
years.
I mean, that's pretty awesome. But maybe it could be you, too.
Oh, no. No, no one knows me.
I'm
no
old.
One gives
it. People like, no, he's still alive. You know what?
God, I knew that guy when I was
Yeah, this could be his last meal. Let's make it special.
Could be his last.
He was fucking old as shit when I was 19.
Shit. How is he still around?
That could be. Could be.
I don't know that they do. This is the most outgoing thing I've probably done since I've opened the restaurant. Even though you'd think opening a restaurant you'd be really outgoing.
No, you don't have time.
Well, more like I just
too busy.
It was like the afterthought. Like I knew I loved all the things about a restaurant. I know I love making the restaurant like work, and I love working for Lucia. I was basically like, I got to do all the things for her, but she got to stand out in the front, you know, and I liked making it all happen. I didn't necessarily think like, oh, people are going to want to say hi to me.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. You're like, wait, they want to talk
I was like,
to
what are they going
to
say? Yeah. And they're like,
people
are
going to ask me on podcasts and shit.
Yeah. What the hell? Oh, crap.
Yeah, but then you gave me cider, so it worked out.
Yeah, I see. Exactly. There's pluses. Yeah.
Maybe take that with a grain of salt because let's face it, starting a restaurant and then COVID breaking out is a weird curve to set the bar to.
Yeah.
So I think it's okay to reinvent yourself within your own space.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like when the universe is going to take care of you.
Yeah.
There it is.
Yeah. It is funny though, when people would ask to talk to me, I'd be like, do you think they're going to complain? What do you think they're going to say?
What's wrong?
Yeah. Yeah. And then they'll be like, they just want to say hi. And I'm like, oh, to me?
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
So it's fun. It's a fun place to be. It's exciting. I'm grateful.
I think whether it's a little brewery or a restaurant or even like a remodeling company or just any little service provider, right? At the end of the day, some people are always going to think like there's way more behind you than what they see. Like, well, you got to have a shitload of money or whatever.
Yeah.
When you open a little restaurant, you've just created a job for yourself at a restaurant.
Yeah. Yeah. Doing something I love doing.
It's not like...
Based on human connection.
Day one, I'm a millionaire.
That's probably not going to happen in this industry.
Yeah. Nor in a lot of
other
ones.
Some people do, but you're not doing it for... When you open a small 30-seat restaurant that's like more... You know, day-to-day food.
Yeah.
I didn't think I was going to become a millionaire and everybody's going to want to meet me. I just thought, hey, let's make some really good stuff that people like.
Yeah.
And get to do what I want to do.
I really do. Why people can't make a good sandwich in this world.
Right. I know.
But when you go to a place, that comes through. You can tell. You walk into a place, you're like, all right.
These
food, you're like,
care.
Okay, they care. This is good.
Yeah,
I mean, different place I've walked into, the tiny little place, you're like, okay, I don't know what's going on, but I'm coming back here to make sure this stays here.
Yeah.
And obviously the neighborhood felt that.
I think that's the case.
I would say that's exactly true. I know my neighbor just recently took over ownership of Sea Salt.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And so she's going to do great with this, and it's going to be a totally different experience for her owning the place.
That's cool.
You know, because she started out as a cook, too. But do you happen to know Kate?
I don't know if I know Kate.
I should introduce you guys.
Yeah, that'd be great. Mm-hmm.
Just because women in business, owning in the restaurant.
Talking the same language.
Go take over the world.
Yeah.
Just
please
do. Fix it.
I know.
Yeah, I know.
Please.
I know. I don't like old men.
No.
Well, I mean, come on.
Present company excluded, right?
Okay. I mean, we're okay.
I was going to say.
Right. Yeah.
That makes
everybody
awkward.
Else sucks.
Yeah, no,
I like
right.
you guys.
No.
You're good.
No, we're middle-aged.
Come on, man.
All right, you guys. Mark's got to go. He's got children. He's got to take care of them. He's got to go pick them up.
I guess.
Heather, this was really fun.
It was awesome.
Yeah, this was so much fun. Thank
you.
Yeah. I'm happy I did it.
Okay, so our expectations of you are that you now double our listenership by putting this everywhere out into the world, because look at how fun it was. It was so awesome. I'm just kidding. Right. You're fine.
I was like, I don't know how to do that, but
I was like, no pressure.
Yeah, make your sandwich.
That's made
so
up.
The other thing is, you have new menu, something coming up, something you're doing. Oh, hey, we have this going on.
Yeah, do you want to, honestly, we do have some people who actually listen to this.
Yeah.
I would call them out right now, but he's got to get going. But like, thank you, Boise, Idaho, and Tallahassee, Florida, and whoever else is listening.
People that's amazing.
All over the place. Yeah.
Yep.
But But yeah, is there
that
anything?
That just made me nervous.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why we don't say it until the end.
Now you got nervous?
Yeah. Dude, dude,
he'll
be Boise.
Fine. Boise, Idaho.
He'll be fine. No, I mean, I think, I do think that, like, sort of talent recruiters from like the Food Network and stuff might listen to this too and say like, oh, we need, I'm just kidding.
Oh, wow. I was like, are they? Go back to Boise, yeah. Idaho. That was already making me nervous. Yeah.
Now you're talking other crap.
That was just a place.
And Malort is coming.
Yeah, yeah, it's coming. Yeah.
To Malort, a theater near Malort you. Venue. Yeah.
Cooking with Malort.
Oh, Lord.
Can you imagine making, if you could take Malort and make something that tasted good, either a cocktail or a
you'd
food item.
You'd be a genius.
You'd fix the world.
Because it's not
the
possible.
World. Okay, well, I have to taste this burnt plastic. That seems a difficult starting point.
Don't
here.
Forget the orange tint to it. But not even orange, like orange rind.
Like tang?
No, it's, yeah. It's no, like...
Like, orange rind.
Yeah, but and not
it's kind
like
of pithy.
Zest. It's okay. Not yeah. Zest.
Oh,
zest
no,
is nice.
No, it's not the. It's
like
not
brown
the zest.
Rind after yeah. It's dried in the sun for a while, oh, and you're
this
like,
sounds awful.
What
no
would
offense,
we do with
Chicago.
That?
Yeah.
No, they
you
suck.
You don't throw it in. Throw it in the. Burn
I mean, they're not a sponsor
bat.
Yet.
Yeah, exactly.
So
we figured they're either going to sponsor, send us right. Money, or a cease and desist.
But if they do, we should do a show where yeah. We have past chef guests
right.
Make a sandwich that goes with Malort. Oh, Courtney Lord. Malort.
And
they bring it all home together.
It would just be person after person going, yeah. I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
I couldn't find anything that tasted good. Made it taste good.
There's some super offensive bulimic joke I could make. I don't know what it is, but like, if you don't like sandwiches and you want to throw up the
you
sandwich
the
that goes
Malort.
With it is
Malort.
The Malort.
It keeps
Malort.
You thin.
Yeah.
Cease and desist. Here we come.
That was terrible. Terrible. I have no idea.
Just
one
just
day.
Circle back to making them feel bad about themselves.
One day.
And they should.
We'll change our tune.
Yeah.
Go to Heather's.
Yeah.
Well,
yes.
Thank you. Yes.
Check it out.
Heather's.
Please do it. Better than Malort.
Yes. You know what?
I mean,
I see your new ads.
Yeah.
Heather's better than Malort.
Yeah, that's our slogan.
There it is. Done.
And you do have a nice wine menu and,
yeah,
and
thank
drink
you.
Menu and all
yeah.
The rest of it, too. So great little place.
Thank you.
Go visit. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you for
thank
having
you.
Me. Yeah, it's
thank
been fun.
You. It's nice
we
to meet
good?
You, Heather.
I feel like
too.
I don't
yeah.
Want the fun to end, but
I know. Well, you're welcome
does.
To come back anytime.
Well, thank
yes.
You.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll figure out other things to talk about. We can talk about whatever.
Yeah.
Every time.
All right.
Bye.
Well, you did it. You made it to the end of another show. Thank you all so much for listening to our show. We really, really appreciate it. Don't forget to send us your questions, comments, or even your guest requests. Maybe you want to be a guest. Maybe you know someone who would be a great guest. Send them in to info@legacymatterspodcast.com. All right. See you next time. Thank you. the theme music and all the other music that you've heard on this show is created by and recorded by the fabulous Captain Al. Check him out. Hey, everyone. Thanks again for listening to our show. I told you I'd have a little something for you at the end of the show, so here I go. I haven't rehearsed. I don't know exactly what I want to say, but the idea is this. I started Legacy Matters like 5 years ago. It's thankfully continued on. We're having so much fun with it these days. It's the best it's ever been. And one thing that I'd really like to do is potentially expand. And so what I'm looking for, if you listen to the show and you really like it and you think that you and a couple of friends might want to take some of the responsibility of interviewing some of the cool people out there in the world, reach out to me and I will help you figure out how to get started. And we can do Legacy Matters in other places. And you can, if you've ever thought about doing a podcast and you want to jump in on one and it's all pre-built, I am here to help. And we can get you going, and we'll do Legacy Matters in remote places because there's people all over the place who have great lives, stories to tell, fun things to do, and if you have friends and you want to do it, let's go. So reach out, get in touch with me. If you want to sponsor our show, we'd love that too. I wasn't joking about that. We'll take sponsors. But that's the big thing, so I'd like to expand. So thanks for listening.